and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a, I want to say an easy look, because in design it's very easy, but it does require a whole lot of blending, so in that sense it's a good exercise. But anyway, I wanted to do a wearable autumn look. Something that could be worn casual, but could also be quite glam. And I wanted to do it in all mattes, except the inner corner highlight, because I just couldn't help myself. But anyway, this is what we're going to end up with. Let's get started. And I'm starting off with eye primer today. I don't know, like if I don't show it, it doesn't feel complete somehow. Yet if I do show it, it sort of feels like something that's so simple that it's pretty much redundant to even show, because you apply eye primer. It's really not, it's basically the easiest step in makeup ever. And once this primer's on there, it's time to apply some transition shades. My idea this time around is to do a matte look, because I've done, not just lately, I always do shimmer and glitter overload. But I've been really, really into the shimmer lately, so I decided to go for a matte look this time. You know, challenging myself, keeping myself sharp, that sort of stuff. So yeah, we're going to go for matte today, but I want to do an autumn glam. A matte, natural colored, or at least brown tones and all, and nude tones, autumn glam. But I do want them in warm shades, because that's, to me, more autumn than cool shades. I don't know, I just prefer warm shades overall. So my transition shade is also quite warm. It's basically a little bit darker than my own skin color, and a little bit more towards the orange side. Like, obviously, you just gotta cater this to your own skin tone. To darken it up a little, I'm going to use a darker brown shade in a warm shade. That sounded more smooth in my head for some reason. But anyway, I'm using a slightly smaller brush for that, slightly more dense, so this really picks up a lot of product and it's a bit more precise than the other brush was. And yeah, I'm just blending it in a round shape this time, because another thing I've been doing a lot lately, and I mean a lot, if I'm putting a bit of plastic against my eye and then automatically get that wing shape. And, you know, I don't want to do... Well, it's a weird thing, really. Like, on one hand, I don't want to do the same eye look over and over again just with different colors. But on the other hand, I do always feel like, I don't know, most of us who wear makeup, you know, we all have this preference of a certain type of look. And I feel that it is usually the sort of look that looks best on, you know, you as a specific person. So I always personally feel like on me it looks best if I remember what shade of brown I picked. But if I do a look that's darker in the crease than on my eyelids, basically. A pale eyelid, I think, looks better on me. And I also always feel that a angled look looks better on me than a rounded look. However, I don't know, like I always strongly believe as well though in like trying out new things and like keep challenging yourself and don't stick to your comfort zone when it comes to makeup, because it's just makeup, it washes off again, so it's like the perfect thing to just go ham with and be adventurous with. So yeah, basically that's my reasoning for doing a look that's out of my comfort zone. Then to darken it up even more, I'm going to go into a smaller brush and, you guessed it, an even darker shade of warm brown. And I'm really placing that in the outer corner. Like basically the outer... It's not really like a half C shape. From the outer corner to like the center of the crease, that's basically the point that I'm trying to make here. I'm just pretty much... putting on a lot of product, and then I'm going to blend it out. I don't want to spread this out too much, but I do want it to be nice and deep. So that's the plan. Also, by the way, if you're, you know, not really interested in making this more of an autumn look, and if, you know, cool tones, and or if, like, if for whatever reason you want to do this in cooler tones, of course, you can just follow these exact same steps, but then just use cool shades of eyeshadow. This is basically just a casual smoky eye tutorial. And the colors are just entirely up to you. Then onto the eyelid, I'm actually going to use not the transition shade, but the shade that came after that. So like the still quite pale, warm brownie shade. Because like I said, like I want to do a smoky eye, but I know that if my eyelid is darker than my crease, then it's just really not going to look good on me. I just know that for sure. So yeah, I'm just applying this shade instead. And I'm just using my blending brush, the dense one. Because it works well. Why is the sun coming out and then disappearing again? It's really annoying. Anyway, then I'm going to go into the slightly darker brown shade. So not the absolute darkest, but the one between the other one. And yeah. You know, a shade that's good for blending the outside corner here. Just to make sure it's all nice and seamless. Then some, obviously, matte highlighter on the brow bone. And after that, I'm just going to blend it with the large fluffy blender just all around it. And I really get annoyed by the sun sometimes. Anyway, and then I think the top eyelid is pretty much done. Now, I'll just go do my face real quick. I'm just using a BB cream because I feel like doing a more natural skin type texture finish today. I'm keeping it away from my eyes for the simple reason that, well, quite frankly, I just applied moisturizer on my eyes, whereas on my face it's more of a case of, I don't want to blend this over my eyeshadow. It's more of a case of, I did apply moisturizer, but that was in the morning, and then after that I had a full day working as a postman, so I basically, I feel like I should probably moisturize my face again. So the BB cream can do that. But yeah, if you do want full coverage, obviously just use a foundation. I'm just applying some more concealer where I want a little bit more coverage. So on some blemishes and also on the bridge of my nose here, where nothing, except for Catrice and Dior, for some reason will actually adhere to. It's like freaking magic. Also, this BB cream was the right color until, oh, or just lie on the floor, whatever. Until I started blending it and then it suddenly became darker. We're just gonna ignore that. Then under my eye I do want a little bit of highlighter. So I'm using a concealer that I'm quite frankly mostly using because it's nearly empty and I really need to finish it. So yep. Oh, and now my lamp dies. You know, I'm having one of those days where it's like, the universe is out to ruin my mood. No, really, it is. Like, seriously, the morning, of course, started with... I did already mention it. I worked this morning as a postman. And anyone who's ever... not just worked as a postman, but just in general... you know... walked outside with paper in their hands. It's annoying when it's raining. It's really annoying. Because you can't keep it dry. You just can't. And it's just... it's so annoying. Then also, I bruised my pinky finger 2 weeks ago when I managed to almost fall down the stairs. Because I'm really smart and all. Oh, and also the sun is annoying me. That too. So yeah, it was blue for like a week. It's not blue anymore, but it still kind of hurts. Like, I could just move it and all. I don't think it's broken or anything. But I smacked it. Like, I tried to grab my bicycle's handle. And I smacked it, like, right against it. Which hurt. Okay, then there was a mishap with the concealer just now. Like, I literally just put it straight up on the table. Oh, I just... I don't want to say I hate the sun, because the sun helps us to be alive. But, oh, I didn't even blend the concealer up here. Anyway, point being, I put the concealer up straight and it basically just jumped off the table. I'm really having one of those days where I feel like the universe is trying to get me into a bad mood. And I refuse. I just plainly refuse. No, really. So I really hope the universe isn't going to, like, I don't know, ruin the audio on this file to, like, try to really, really make me angry. Now I'm just setting the concealer and everything else with powder. And by the way, the concealer I use is the Skin Tone Concealer by Kiko. I do actually like it. I like how it feels, because you don't actually feel it. But one downside is that I don't really think it has the best coverage. Like, I feel like I don't know, I would like a little bit more coverage personally. But yeah, like, I'm still going to blend brown underneath my eyes as well, so it doesn't really matter all that much. But yeah, just so you know, in case you're interested, it's really good for natural days though. Also, as always, all the products I use will be listed below the video in the description. And as always, you don't need to use the exact same brands that I used. Like, basically, I just put it there just so, if you want to know, you can know, but like, it's not like you can't do this look with different products. Like, if you use the other products, and like the same colors of eyeshadow but a different brand and stuff, then, you know, you can also easily do this look. So don't let it stop you. Next up, I think I'm just going to finish the eyes first and then actually do the face, and we'll do that together as well, because why not? But I'm going to go into my brush. I'm going to use this brush to go into the, not the darkest, but the second to darkest brown shade that I used. Yeah. And I'm going to apply that beneath my eye on the outer corner. Really connected with the outer corner. And just drag it inwards. And then I'm going to move to a tiny fluffy blender with a mixture of the second shade and the first shade. So the transition shade and the shade I use after that. I basically just want my transition shade but a little bit darker. And with that I'm just going to blend this out. And really make sure that you go along with the circle shape here in the outer corner and all. So you really connect the bottom and the top, and it's not like top and then randomly the bottom. I really want this to be one shape. So I'm really just blending this around the eye basically. Well, around the outer corner at least. Just to make sure everything, you know, becomes one look. Like so. A little bit more actually. Better to just keep applying than to apply too much at once. But yeah, I think we're good here. I'm a bit of a perfectionist, does it show? Okay, I'm gonna leave it alone. Then I'm going to do my waterline. I'm going to do that with a dark brown pencil. This is an ancient one by Estee Lauder. I recommend using one that's not ancient. But this is my only brown eye pencil. So yeah. I'm also filling in that inner corner here. And I'm also going to pull this upwards, but only to where my eyelashes start. Because I like that intensity on my own eye shape. One brow is already present. We're going to do the other one as well. And I'm just going to use my eyeshadow palette for that too. Because realistically, if I'm being lazy and I want to use one palette, then I want to use it for absolutely everything. And the palette I'm using, by the way, is Jeffree Star Cosmetics Orgy Palette. Other palettes for natural looks, especially autumn looks that I like, are Urban Decay Born to Run. That doesn't only contain nude shades, but, you know, it does roughly contain the shades that I use today as well. I also like Warm Brown Obsessions by Huda Beauty. Although that does have the downside that it doesn't have a highlighting shade that's pale enough for me. But yeah, anyway, just gonna fill in my brows like usual. Now, I actually still want to apply falsies, but I'm gonna do my face first and then apply the falsies so I can live a little bit longer without falsies on my eyes, I guess. I don't want to get like powder over top of the falsies and make them paler is basically the thing. But I'm just grabbing an eyeshadow now and just doing quite a sharp contour. I didn't really mean to do a very sharp contour actually, but it turned out that way on the other side because I forgot I was using an eyeshadow, even though I was literally grabbing it from an eyeshadow palette. And that's typically a bit more pigmented than the average contour product. I applied a little bit too much is what I'm trying to say, and now I'm just evening it out with the other side. But yeah, just a nice cool shade. I don't want to do bronzer obviously because as usual I made my face darker than my neck again and I don't want to make that worse. So yeah, just a nice contour it is. For a blush I obviously am going to use a different palette and I'm using one with a bit of shimmer in it. Not too much of it, of course. But with a bit of shimmer in it, and I'm applying it quite far backwards, so it can also be my highlighter today, basically. And yeah, just a nice warm shade, and obviously just blend it really well with the contour too. And now setting spray, just really quickly in between before I finish the eyes and the lips. I'm actually going to use one that's a bit more dewy than what I usually use. I usually use the mattifying one, D-Slick by Urban Decay. Now I'm using a different one because I'm all matte and I want a little bit more glow in it. Actually, I just decided that I do want a little bit of highlighter, actually shimmery highlighter in my inner corner. So I'm just using a white gold-ish one by Kiko, which looks quite natural, but it, you know, does just give a little bit more glow. And I also have it on with Cupid's bow. Then lashes. Obviously, I did not do any eyeliner, so I'm going to use a pair that's quite natural and most importantly has a clear lash band. So yeah, this is the before. And after, I'm just gonna apply some mascara on my bottom lashes and then we can move on to lips. The lips I'm going to do nude, but I do want to have a nude with a bit of shimmer in it because everything else is very matte. So yeah, I just want to offset it a little bit by having the lips shimmery. And that leaves us with the final results. Yeah, I actually quite like how it turned out. Like, personally, I prefer the shimmery with the matte just because I'm just not the type of person who goes for an all matte look as usually. But if you do want an all matte look, then, you know, I would recommend picking a shade that's like the same color as the eyelid and putting that on your lips. And I think that would look really, really cool as well. But yeah, that's basically it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. If you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. I upload 3 times per week. Yes, I'm pointing the exact correct number of fingers for once. It's a miracle. Anyway, that aside. And 2 of those are makeup tutorials. And yeah, that was it for today. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day. And I hope to see you next time. Bye!